I finally had a chance to play a bit with the 12 new Lavinia stencils, and in today's 5 minutes of fun video, I'll show you samples made with different kinds of media, plus I'll demo a couple of techniques. These stencils are wonderfully unique, and I really think you're going to enjoy creating with them. As always, our everyday discount means 15% off is automatically applied, and you'll find links below. This release includes a range of natural imagery with lots of flora and fauna, plus some really pretty, very organic overall patterns. And not only are they perfectly suited for creating with Lavinia stamps, they're marvelous for all kinds of non-fairy themed creating, which is what I'm going to focus on today. I'm not even going to bring in the stamps. So the design area is not quite 6 inches wide, but you can see on this 6x6 page, I just let it kind of gradually fade off. Doesn't matter that it doesn't fit the entire page, and there are going to be times when you only want a little piece of it. So allow it to fade out gracefully, make it a hard line, whatever works for whatever it is that you're working on. Now the other thing that I almost always do is print what's left on the stencil before I clean it off, and that's what you see here. So this is the design as I spritzed through the openings, and then this is what's left when I printed it. Now some of the time, depending on the colors that you're working with, you might find, like I did here, I liked this design, but I found that it stood out much better on this black smooth and sturdy tag if I outlined it with a metallic pen. So you're going to be able to realize those kinds of things as you go along and play. So the first thing I'm going to do is bring in one of our index cards. This is 5x7. This is the stencil named Pods, and I'm going to use two colors of Oxide sprays just to spritz through it, and then I'll go ahead and I'll print. So I have Twisted Citron and Worn Lipstick. Now obviously these are going to be muddy if I allow them to really combine, but I'm not going to do that. Instead what I'm going to do is just overlap them a little bit, and because oxides are opaque, that's going to work out just fine. So I'll start off with some of the green at the bottom, and then I'll use some of the pink at the top. Well, my mister doesn't want to work. And you can see that with the overlap, I don't have, oh, I love this design. I don't have a lot of mud going on. In fact, I don't have any mud going on, but I do have this really nice design. So let's grab a piece of paper towel and just mop up what's here. Now, ordinarily, I would do something with this. I would dip something plain into it to get a background going, but for today, I'm not going to. So another one of the index cards, and I'm just going to turn this over and print it. Now I'm going to bring in a blank piece of paper so that I can press it down. The way you'll get the best print is to make certain that the wet areas of that stencil come in contact with whatever you're printing it on. And so I'm using the heel of my hand to really rub that in place. And then when I lift this up, how awesome is that? You get this design. Again, I don't have any mud going on because I really haven't allowed these to blend. So let me put these off to one side, get them out of the way. And then the other thing that works when we talk about printing is you can actually even do this with designs from a stencil, excuse me, with designs from an ink pad. So I'm going to bring this in. I have three colors of Oxide ink pads. I have Twisted Citron, Cracked Pistachio, and Peacock Feathers. I'm going to start with the light, I'm going to work my way to dark, and I'm not even going to change the pad on the mini ink blending tool. I'm just going to go along with this, and then I want to show you that even though there's not what looks like a lot of anything on here, not a ton of color, I can actually mist it with water and then go ahead and print it. All right, here's my water container. So I'm going to start with the Twisted Citron. I've got some color on there. Oops, and I'm going to go ahead, and I'm not being fancy or fussy here. I just want to get color on to show you the technique. I really don't care what this looks like so much as I care that I'm going to give you an idea of how this works. Now, I haven't taped this down, and obviously that can be an issue, but it's not a big deal here. All right, so I'm going to come back and overlap this a little bit. Again, it doesn't look like there's a lot of color on here. Now, the thing to bear in mind is that the Twisted Citron is reasonably light, but it will still print. So let me come in and grab some of the Peacock Feathers and then go ahead and do this along the top. Now, I'm not being careful how I'm blending. I'm just putting color down. Ordinarily, I would be a little bit more deliberate so that I wouldn't get hard lines, but for the sake of argument today, we'll just do what we do. So this really, a nice design, leaves you, you could come in and doodle in these openings if you wanted. So again, let's just quickly wipe this up. So what I'm going to do, slide those out of the way, is mist this stencil with just enough water to activate the ink that's on there. If I could pick it up, again, wiping. And then I'm going to do the same thing. I'll bring in another index card, turn this over, and I'm going to bring in that same piece of paper. Now, the design is not going to be quite as obvious when I printed what was left from the oxide sprays, because I simply don't have the volume of media on that stencil as I did, but I can still get this effect. So when I pick this up, you can see, how cool is that? You get this very soft, very model looking imprint, which again, if I bring this one back in, is quite different. But when you're looking to create interesting pattern and texture, this is simply another way to do exactly that. All right, so let's cover these ink pads up and get them out of the way. Now, I love all things that are shimmery, as evidenced by this. I mean, this shouldn't come as a surprise to most of you that shimmer is my deal. So you can see here that I've done that, whoops, turn it this way. I've done the same thing where I've spritzed and then I've printed. This is shimmery, you can't hate that. So the thing I want to show you now that I'm working with are the Viva Decor Precious Metal Colors. So when you look at these, if I hold this up to the light, you can see that this goes from pink to copper. So this is actually, I think it's rose pink, this is copper, and this is turquoise. And again, I deliberately faded out here. Really simple to do, again, with a mini ink blending tool. So let me bring in another stencil and I'll show you that. Now this one is named Stones, and I've got some oxide sprays on a, this looks like it's a 4x6 index card. Now the thing with the precious metal color is that you have to shake it. So I'm going to do that. Now these are on special clearance. They are 50% off. They are not available anymore in the US. In fact, I'm not even certain if Viva Decor even offers them any longer. So what I do is use something pointy to get that seal off on the inside. Let's see if I can just peel this off so it's out of the way. Now obviously there's more than one way to skin a cat, but for me, I want to put this cover back on and shake this some more. There is a mixing bowl in there. I can't hear it in this one. There it goes. I can just begin to hear it. So what I'm going to do, again, another mini ink blending tool with a clean foam. So I'm just going to turn this over and go ahead and get some color on the mini ink blending tool. I don't want to overdo it because I won't get a crisp impression, but this should be fine now. Now, none of this is rocket science. None of this is revolutionary. None of this is new, but it's all things that you can do with these stencils that make the whole thing so interesting. So I'm just going to kind of edge this and create a center area where there is no pattern, which could become a focal point for whatever. All right, so let's bring this out. This is one of those organic designs that I mentioned. So again, very effective. Now this is kind of a busy background. So let's do this on the back where we can get a better idea of what this looks like. Same thing, I'm just going to move my way around the perimeter of the stencil. And once I pick this up, you'll be able to see that's a little bit better way to see what all of this is about. And now if I had one of the stamps, I could come and I could stamp it in here. So again, there are 12 stencils in this initial release. Let's bring the pods back in because that really is my favorite. There are 12 stencils in this initial release. I finally had a chance to play with them. I think that they're marvelous, and I really think that you're going to have fun with them too.